Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to Analysis of Indeterminate Structures. In today's session, let us solve simple portal frame subjected to loading as shown in figure. In flexibility approach, we solve sway frame and no sway frames by using unit load method to find the unknown displacements and flexibility coefficients. In beams, we have used conjugate beam method, and in sinking beams, we have used unit load approach, and the same unit load approach can be used while solving frames also. And again, the entire solution has been divided into simple steps to understand the problem easily. So let us solve this particular problem stepwise. As usual, in step number one, we need to find the degree of static indeterminacy. You all know degree of static indeterminacy we can find by using the simple approach, number of unknowns minus number of available equilibrium conditions. And also we have one more formula to find this degree of static indeterminacy, that is Km plus R minus Nj. For portal frames, we can take this as 3m plus r minus 3j. So here 3, we have 3 members A, B, B, C and C, D, and the number of reactions are 6, and we have 4 joint. If you solve this particular equation, 9 plus 6 15, 15 minus 12, it is 3. Or you can go for another method, that is number of unknowns here. At A and D, we have two fixed supports. For 1 6 fixed supports, we have 3 unknowns. In frame, we need to take the axial condition also. In beams, we were neglecting that, but in frames, we need to take that axial condition also. So if you take that into account, we get 6 number of unknowns, 3 per 1 support, and available equilibrium conditions are 3, sigma fx, sigma fi and sigma mz. Therefore, the total DSI is 3. So you can use this formula, that is Km plus R minus Nj, in beams also. But this is a simple approach to find the degree of static indeterminacy. As usual, this is our first step. After finding the degree of static indeterminacy, we can assume the redundance. And once we find the degree of static indeterminacy, we immediately get to know the size of the matrix. Here, the size of the matrix is 3 cross 3, that is flexibility matrix is always a square matrix, and the order is 3 cross 3, and the number of unknowns will be 3, that is a P matrix. Remember, this flexibility relation D minus DL equals to F into P. So this is the flexibility relation. Here P is the unknown. The order is 3 cross 1 and F is 3 cross 3, and again DL matrix is also 3 cross 1 and this D matrix is also 3 cross 1. Both this D and P matrices are column matrix, and F matrix is a square matrix, and this decides the order of flexibility matrix. Now we need to assume the redundance. Here let us take the redundance at support A. At support A, I assume the redundance as reaction at A, that is vertical reaction at A can be taken as RAV, horizontal reaction at A can be taken as RAH, and moment at A can be taken as MAB or MA. Clear? So these three are the redundants, and you can call this as P1, P2 and P3. Finally, we are going to find these unknown forces. Now, let us mark these redundants on the given structure. This is the given frame. So we need to mark these redundants on the given frame. So at A, we have vertical reaction and horizontal reaction and one moment. So this is RAV, this is RAH, and this is MAB. So this is point A, this is B and D. So this is called released determinant structure. And we should also show the coordinate directions along the direction where we have marked the redundants. We have marked the redundants at support A, and we have marked vertical reaction upward and horizontal reaction to the left side, and moment in a clockwise direction. And we considered these directions as positive. Therefore, the coordinate directions will be at A, RAB becomes coordinate number 1, and RAH coordinate number 2, and MAB coordinate number 3. So this is figure C, which shows the general coordinate directions. This completes step number 1. As usual, we find the degree of static indeterminacy and we assume the redundants, and we mark the assumed redundants on the given structure, and this gives me the released structure, and we also show the coordinate directions, and whatever the directions we have marked, they will be treated as positive. In step number 2, we use the unit load approach to find the unknowns. And you all know, in unit load approach, we make use of a simple formula. That is, to find any displacements, either theta or delta, it is integral of within the limit 0 to L, M into, that is capital M into small m, into dx divided by EI. The same expression we have used while solving the sinking beam. So here you all know, capital M is the bending moment at the sections because of the applied loading. That means to find the M, we use the released structure. And this small m gives me the bending moment at the particular section because of the unit loads. And we are going to apply the unit loads at each coordinates. And we check the moment at each sections. Let us apply the unit load at each coordinate and let us write the free body diagram. So if we apply the unit load at coordinate number 1, so you all know, while applying unit load, we need to remove all other loadings. That means we should not consider the applied loading while applying the unit load. So at coordinate number 1, we should apply the unit load, that is 1 kilonewton. Clear? So this is 6 meters. 6. Span remains as it is. This is point A, B, C and D. And at coordinate number 2, again we apply the unit load. And at coordinate number 3, it's a moment. Therefore, there we can apply the unit couple or unit moment. Call it as 1 kilonewton meters. And if you observe, in all the three structures, we have removed the applied loading. Call this as figure D, figure E, and figure F. And this gives me the unit load at coordinate number 1, unit load at coordinate number 2, and unit load at coordinate number 3. Once we are ready with these free body diagrams, we can easily formulate the standard table. That means we need to take the moments at the individual sections. So let us write the table. As usual, the standard table consists of the segments and origin, limits, and information about variation in EI, then bending moment due to the applied load and bending moments due to the unit loads. We have three unit loads at three different coordinates, therefore we get three bending moments, that is M1, M2 and M3. Look at the structure. We have three segments, AB, BC and CD. From one point to another point, we can consider as one single segment. And in between, if you find any loading, then you have to consider a separate segment. That I explain in next problem. So here, if you look at the structure, we have three segments here, from A to B one segment, from B to C another segment, and from C to D the last segment. Therefore, we have AB and BC, then CD. So these are the three segments we have. Then we are coming from the left hand side, that means we are coming from A. Therefore I can take for segment AB, A as origin, and the section XX moves like this. Therefore for section BC, that is the for segment BC, you can take B as origin, and for the last segment you can take C as origin. Based on the origin, we can write the limits. Even for all the segments, you can keep A as origin. That is another method. So for this problem, I have kept for AB A as origin. Therefore, the limits are 0 to 6. Clear? AB span has a limit of 0 to 6 with A as origin. In the same manner, if I check for span BC, the keeping B as origin, the limits are, this is the starting point, therefore it varies from 0 to 6. And again, for the last segment, again the limits are 0 to 6. Now, if you check the variation of EI, in the question they have given, EI is constant. Therefore, you can write it as 1. Now, we need to take the moment at these segments by considering the sections. This M we can get by referring figure B, that is released structure, and M1 because of the unit load at 1. So you can write the reference figures here. Figure D, figure E and figure F. So now let us mark the sections. Keeping A as origin, if I take the section XX here, so this will be the distance small x. Now I need to take moment about this point. See? So to take the moment about this point, to the right side of this section, I don't find any loading. Therefore, moment about that point for segment AB is 0. Likewise, if you check the segment BC, you need to take the variable section like this, and we should take the moment about this point, and this will be the horizontal distance. And we have lateral loading, but this passes through the line of action. Therefore, at that particular point also, the moment is 0. And now, by keeping C as origin, if I take the segment This will be the distance. Now I should take the moment about this point. So this will be, see, from the principle of transmissibility, I can take 20 here. So 20 into x, and that acts in clockwise direction. And here we have taken the clockwise moment as positive. Therefore, it is plus 20 into x. We are just taking the moments by following the simple sign conventions. Force into perpendicular distance, and here we have moving from the left hand side, therefore the clockwise moments are taken as positive. This 20 into x acts in clockwise direction, therefore it will be treated as positive. In the same manner, we should take the moments for all these three structures also. Just we are going to repeat the same step to find m1, m2 and m3, but we refer the different diagrams. That's it. So if you take figure D, you need to take the section here, again keeping A as origin. So this is x. Take moment about this point. It's a bending moment, you all know. Bending moment either you can take to the left of the section or to the right of the section. So I am taking to the left of the section. Because of this one, if you can get the moment, you can write that moment there. So this one again passes through the same point. Therefore, because of this 1 kilonewton, about this point, I am not getting any kind of moment. Therefore, this is zero. Now, mark the section in segment BC. This is taken as X. Now, from the principle of transmissibility, this one can be taken to this B point, 1 into X, and it acts in clockwise direction. Again, therefore, this is X. Again, here for CD segment, you can take the section like this. Again, this one will be taken to the B point. So 1 into perpendicular distance is 6, and this acts in clockwise direction. If you have the moment 6 here, the same moment will be act at this point also. Therefore, here the moment is 1 into 6, it is 6. Since it is acting in clockwise direction, it will be taken as positive. So if you take the figure E, so this segment is taken as XX, horizontal, this is distance from A to X. Now take moment about this point. So if you take moment about this point, 1, and the perpendicular distance is X, it is 1 into X, and again it's acting in clockwise direction, therefore it is taken as plus X. And in the second segment, if you take the section, so this 1 into perpendicular distance is 6, and it acts in clockwise direction. If you get 6 kilonewton meters at B point, the same moment will be act at this point also. 1, the perpendicular distance is 6. 1 into 6, you get 6 kilonewton meter at point B. The same moment will be act at this particular point also. Therefore, the moment is plus 6. And the last section, this is taken as X. So now, if you have 1 kilonewton at this position, the same load will be act here in a different direction, 1 kilonewton, and this distance can be taken as 6 minus X. For this particular column, we will take moment from the right hand side. So here it is 1 into the perpendicular distance is 6 minus X, and we get the moment as 6 minus X. Since we are taking moment from the right hand side, so this moment acts in anti-clockwise direction. From the right hand side, anti-clockwise is taken as positive. Therefore, it is positive 6 minus X. So it will be easier if I calculate moment like this. So or else I need to consider reactions and all. So that will increases the complexity of the problem. That's why we have taken moment from the right hand side for this particular column. Now, the last structure, that is unit load applied at coordinate number 3, and it is applied in the form of moment because the redundant is moment at coordinate number 3. Now, again, consider the sections in the individual segments like this. This is section X, and here also we have X, and here also we have section XX, and this distance is taken as X. And we have 1 kilonewton meter applied in clockwise direction at point A. So, if you take moment because of this particular load at this point or this point or this point, it will be 1 kilonewton itself. Because moment will be acting at A, the same moment will be transferred to all the points. Therefore, the moment at all the segments will be 1, 1 and 1, and all the moments are in positive sense because they are acting in clockwise direction. So this completes the standard table. So all these steps are included in step number 2, that is writing the free body diagrams for individual unit loads, and from that unit loads we can get the moments at different section by formulating the standard table like this. And this table plays a very, very important role to calculate the D matrix and F matrix. Now, in step 3, with the help of this flexibility relation, that is D minus DL equals to F into P, we find all these unknown elements. So first we can find this DL matrix. You all know DL matrix is nothing but displacement due to the applied loading. So it is a column matrix of order 3 cross 1, D1L, D2L and D3L. And to find these elements, D1L, that is displacement at coordinate number 1 because of the applied loading, we can use the simple formula M into M1 into DX divided by EL. So we should do the summation of all the individual segments by multiplying the quantities of M and M1. So here M into M1 for segment AB, it is 0 into 0, 0. And for segment BC, M into M1, 0 into X, again it is 0. And we have M into M1 for only the segment CD within the limits 0 to 6. Therefore, it is 0 to 6. M is 20 into X and M1 is 6 into DX divided by EI. If you have the variation of EI as 2, you have to write 2 here. Since we have EI variation as constant, we have taken it as 1, therefore it is EI itself. And if you solve this particular equation, you are going to get the value for D1L. It's a simple integration. Even you can solve this particular equation manually or with the help of calculator. So we are going to get the value of D1L as 2160 by EI. In the same manner, if you find the displacement at coordinate number 2 because of the loading, so the same formula, it is 0 to L, M into, since we are considering the coordinate number 2, it will be M2, M into M2 divided by EI. Again, we should sum up all the values for segment AB, BC and CD. So now, 0 into X, it is 0, 0 into 6, again it is 0. We have only 20X into 6 minus X. So it is 0 plus 0 plus 0 to 6, the limits for this particular segment, 0 to 6, 20x into 6 minus x into dx divided by EI, and look at the variation of EI, it is 1. Just simply write the EI. Just for your reference, I am writing this is from span AB, segment AB, this is from segment BC, and this is for segment CD. So now, if you solve this particular equation, you can get the value of D2L as, it is 720 by EI. Like this, we can calculate the value for D3L, that is displacement at coordinate number 3, because of the loading, applied loading. It is 0 to L, integral of 0 to L, M into M3 into dx divided by EI. So now, for all the individual segments, for segment AB, 0 into 1, it is 0. 0 into 1, again it is 0. We have 20x into 1. You can write that. For AB it is 0, for BC it is 0. For CD it is 0 to 6. The limits are 0 to 6 and it is 20x into 1. It becomes 20x itself divided by EI. And if you solve this particular equation, you are going to get the D3 value as 360 by EI. So this gives me the values of D1L, D2L and D3L. Now we take up the F matrix. So you all know F is a square matrix and we have 9 elements inside this matrix as F11, F21, F31 and the second column F12, F22 and F32. And the last column is F13 and F23 and F33. So you all know here I position gives the displacement and jth position gives me the load. That means F11 means it is a rotation at coordinate number 1 because of the unit load applied at coordinate number 1. That means here we are going to apply the unit load at coordinate number 1 and we check the displacement at each coordinates. So now here to get the F11 we use the formula integral of 0 to L M1 into M1 dx divided by EI. F11 therefore M1 into M1. This gives me the displacement at coordinate number 1 because of the applied load at coordinate number 1. Like that we can have next element is F21. If you look into the first column and F21 is symmetrical to F12. Therefore, if you find F21, it is enough. The same value can be utilized in the place of F12. Clear? Because F21 and F12 are symmetrical. For this, the formula is 0 to L within the integral limits M2 into M1 or M1 into M2. And next element is F31 and F31 is a displacement at coordinate number 3 because of the unit load applied at 1 and F31 is symmetrical to F13. So if you find F31 it is enough. The same value can be utilized in the place of F13 also. And for this the formula is within the integral limits of 0 to L. It is M3 into M1 or M1 into M3 into dx divided by EI. So by referring the standard table, we can have all the elements here, that is M1, M2, M3. And if you substitute in the respective position and if you do the integration, we can get the values of F11, F21 and F31. So let us solve this. For this, it is M1 into M1. 0 into 0, 0. For span AB, it is 0. For span BC, that is for segment BC, it is x square, x into x, x square. For CD, it is 6 into 6, 6 square. Therefore, I get 0 plus integral of 0 to 6, x square dx divided by EI plus integral of 0 to 6, 6 into 6, 6 square dx divided by EI. So if you solve this AB, BC and CD, so you get the value for F11 and the value is 288 by EI. Got it? Like this you can solve for the remaining flexibility elements also. See, M2 into M1, 0 into x, 0, x into 6, 6x, 6 into 6 minus x. So substitute here, it is the first element is 0, and for the second one it is 0 to 6 x into 6 into dx divided by ei plus 0 to 6 6 into 6 minus x into dx divided by ei. Clear? A, B, B, C and C, D. And if you solve this particular equation, you are going to get the value for F21 as 216. It is 216 by EI. So let us solve the last one, that is F31 and F13 in the first column elements. So for span AB, 0 into 1, again it is 0. Then X into 1, it is X. 6 into 1, it is 6. Within the limits 0 to 6. The first element is 0, for second segment it is 0 to 6, x into 1 it is x into dx divided by ei, and for the last element it is 0 to 6, 6 into 1 it is 6, 6 into dx divided by ei. If you solve this particular equation, you are going to get the value for F31 or F13 as 54 divided by ei. So like this, we can get the remaining elements. In second column elements, already we have got F12. The remaining elements are F22 and F33. And if you get F32, this is symmetrical to F23. Therefore, we need to find 1, 2, 3. Three elements. That's it. Now, in second column elements, we should find F22. F12 we already got. So, F22, it is 0 to L, M2 into M2 dx divided by EI. So for all the segments, just do the M2 square, x square, 6 square and 6 minus x whole square within the integral limits. It is 0 to 6, x square into dx divided by EI for the second span, 0 to 6, 6 square into dx divided by EI and for the last segment it is 0 to 6, 6 minus x whole square into dx divided by ei. So if you solve this particular equation, you are going to get the value for F22 and the value is 360 by ei. Next, in the second column elements, we'll find F32. So if you have F32, the formula will be 0 to L M3 into M2 into dx divided by ei. And this is also equals to F23 because these two are symmetrical. So now it is 2 into 3, x into 1 it is x, 6 into 1 it is 6, then 6 minus x into 1 it is 6 minus x itself. For individual span if you apply 0 to 6, x into 1 it is x into dx divided by ei plus 6 into 1. 0 to 6, it is 6 dx divided by ei and the last one it is 0 to 6, 6 minus x into dx divided by ei. And if you solve this particular equation, we are going to get the value of F32 as 72 divided by ei. Now if you come to the third column element, we have already got F31 and F23. We need to find the one element, that is F33. So that is nothing but integral of 0 to L M3 into M3 dx divided by EI. For all the segments you just multiply M3, for all the segments you just take the values from M3. It is 0 to 6, 1 square into dx divided by EI. 1 into 1 it is 1 square. Again 0 to 6, 1 square into dx divided by EI plus 0 to 6, 1 square into dx divided by ei. If you solve this particular equation, you are going to get the value for F33 as 18 by ei. So now we got all the 9 elements, you know, F matrix. Just substitute them. So in all the 9 elements, we have ei as common. Take out ei outside. So fill the elements column wise. So the first element is 288. The second element is 216. and the third element in first column is 54. And F12, you know F21 and F12 are symmetrical, therefore F12 is 216, and F22 and F22 is 360, and F32 is 72. And you know these two elements are symmetrical, therefore it is 54, and this is 72, and F33 is 18. So this gives me the F matrix. Now we got DL matrix and F matrix. If you substitute the values in this respective equation, and if you do the simple mathematical operations, we can get the value for P, that is RAV, RAH and MAB. Yes, in step 3 itself, now we need to fill the values in the respective position, and we all know we won't get this D matrix here. The D matrix is equals to 0 because there is no any sinking or rotation at the supports. Clear? Only if we have sinking of supports, we need to consider this D, that is displacement matrix. Or else, just we need to find the displacement matrix because of loading and flexibility matrix and the unknown force matrix. So now, you know the elements for DL. If I take the EI common there, so I have D1L as 2160 and D2L as 720 and D3L as 360. And just now we fill the F matrix, it is 1 by EI is common here, and we have the elements like 288, 216 and 54 here, and again here 216, and the second element is 360. And here we have 72, and this is 18 here. So this is the F matrix, and P, you can write it as P1, P2, P3 or RAV, RAH and MAV. Clear? I'll just write it as P1, P2 and P3. Now here EN gets cancelled here. So if you solve this particular equation by applying the principles of matrix, so you can easily get the values of P1, P2 and P3. You can easily solve this with the help of calculators. So we have P1, P2 and P3 equals to, the equation will be in this sense. This comes this side, that means to the denominator. Therefore, the F matrix become F inverse. It is 288, 216, 54 and 216, 360, 72. And 54, 72 and 18 inverse multiplied by the DL matrix. Here you should multiply the minus sign inside. So minus 2160, minus 720 and minus 360. If you solve this particular equation, you are going to get the values for P1, P2, P3. See, this is 3 cross 3 and this is 3 cross 1. So this matches. Therefore, we are going to get the next matrix in the order 3 cross 1. That is this P matrix. You all know at coordinate number 1, we have RAV. At coordinate number 2, we have RAH. And at coordinate number 3, we have MAB. And the values are RAV is minus 8.571. And RAH plus 10 and MAB is minus 34.28 kilonewton meter. Here it is a load kilonewton, and this is also horizontal reaction, and this is the moment. Once we arrive at this particular equation, we can mark these unknowns on the given structure. So you all know the given structure is like this. With a lateral load 20 kilonewton at point B, this is A and this is B, C and this is D. This is the given frame. So here, see, initially I have assumed the reaction direction, what for vertical reaction in upward, horizontal left side, and moment in the clockwise direction. If you have got the positive answers, we should retain the direction as it is, or else we should change the direction. Look here. So RAV, we have got the negative answer. That means we should change the direction. Initially, I have assumed in the upward direction. Since I have got the negative value, I should change the direction like this. And RAH plus 10, I have assumed to the left side. Here also retained the same. RAH is plus 10. And MAB, I have taken in the clockwise direction. Here, I should change the direction like this. This is 34.28 kilonewton meter. We need to transfer all these forces and moments onto the given structure like this. Now, here, to sketch BMD and elastic curve, we should find the final end moments. So, we get the final end moments here at point B and at point C and at D also. Clear? And all these moments are unknown. And we are going to find all these moments by using simple static equations. So, let us find these final end moments. And once we got the final end moments, we can easily sketch the bending moment diagram and elastic curve. So to find the final end moments, I just take the free body diagram of individual segments along with the forces and moments. If I take span AB, so here I have the reaction 8.571 kilonewton. And the horizontal reaction 10 kilonewton and the moment 34.28 kilonewton meters, and the length of this particular column is 6 meters, and here the total load 20 kilonewton is acting. To balance the structure, here we have got 10 kilonewton at this position, this will be 10 kilonewton. And since 8.57 is acting in downward direction, here it will be 8.571 in upward direction. And here the moment MBA is unknown, and you can assume this MBA in any direction, either in clockwise or anticlockwise. Initially I don't know this value. I should find this value MBA. Clear? So how to find that? Now take moment about B point, summation of MB equals to 0, clockwise moment as positive. I take clockwise moment as positive. So if you take the clockwise moments, see MBA is acting in clockwise plus, and this is acting in anticlockwise, therefore minus 34.28. And because of this vertical reaction passes through the same point, therefore you won't get any moment because of this vertical reaction. But because of this horizontal reaction, we get some amount of moment about point B. This 10 into 6 gives me 60 kilonewton meters. And this acts in clockwise direction, therefore it is positive. These are the only forces which creates moment about this point B, and this should be equals to 0. And if you solve this particular equation, the moment at B point, that is MBA, will be equals to minus 25.72 kilonewton meters. I have assumed the direction in clockwise, but have got negative answer. That means the moment is acting in anticlockwise direction. On the given structure where you mark the final end moments, there you mark the direction in anti-clockwise direction like this, because MBA is negative. And you all know from the equilibrium condition at point B, MB equals to MBA plus MBC, correct? So here MBA plus MBC have got, and this should be equals to 0. This is a joint equilibrium condition. Since I have got MBA in negative sense, MBC should be equals to positive 25.72 kilonewton meters. And we apply this joint equilibrium condition at point C also. So now, this is in clockwise direction. This both moments are 25.72 kilonewton meters. And this is also 25.72 kilonewton meters. So now, to find the moment at C, you should take the span BC now, the free body diagram of span BC. If I take the free body diagram of span BC, it will be like this. This is B and this is C. And here, to maintain the equilibrium, so since at this point the vertical reaction is acting in upward, here the vertical reaction should be acting in downward direction. And to balance this 10, another 10 kilonewton will be acts in left side direction. And again, to balance this structure here, 8.571 will acts like this, and this 10 acts in this direction. And at B, you can find this moment. This is 25.72 in clockwise direction. Just now we got this value. And at C, MCB is the unknown moment. Therefore, you can mark that unknown moment in clockwise direction. So this is the free body diagram for span BC. Now, if you take moment about C, you can get the value. MC equals to 0, clockwise as positive. Look here, take moment about this particular point. So it is minus 8.571 into 6. It's acts in anti-clockwise direction. Then plus 25.72. It's a moment, acts in clockwise direction. Then plus MCB equals to 0. So if you solve this particular equation, you are going to get the value of MCB as plus 25.72 kilonewton meters. Since you have got the positive value, whatever the direction you have assumed is correct. Clear? This direction can be assumed either in positive sense or negative sense, or clockwise or anticlockwise. Now, mark the value here. Since I have got MCB as positive, so you can mark it in clockwise direction. Again, if you apply the joint equilibrium condition like this, the value of MCD will be taken as minus 25.72. Again, C is the intermediate joint. Therefore, MC equals to MCB plus MCD equals to 0. Now, MCD is negative moment. Therefore, mark it in anti-clockwise direction. And these two moments values are 25.72 kilonewton meters, and this also 25.72 kilonewton meters. Now we left with the last moment, that is MDC. Again, we need to take moment about D by considering the free body diagram of span CD to find this moment. If you consider the span CD, the free body diagram of span CD, I have anticlockwise moment of value 25.72 kilonewton meters here. At C, to balance the structure, we have 10 kilonewton acting like this. To balance this, at D, we have 10 kilonewton lateral load like this. And here, since at A, we have 8.57 in downward direction, at D, 8.57 should be acts in upward direction. And at C, again, the 8.571 should be acts in downward direction. And here we don't know the moment, that is MDC, and you can take this in positive sense. Now take moment about D as 0 by considering clockwise moments as positive. So if you take moment about this point, it is minus 25.721, it is anti-clockwise moment, and this is plus MDC. And because of this 10 kilonewton lateral load, we get moment about D, that is 10 into 6, and it's acting in clockwise direction. Therefore, it is 10 into 6. This should be equals to 0. If you solve this particular equation, you are going to get the value of MDC as, it is minus 34.28 kilonewton meters. I've marked the MDC in positive sense. Since I've got the negative value, just change the direction on the given structure. Minus 34.28, therefore this will be acting in anti-clockwise direction. So after getting the unknown values from P matrix, we need to find the final end moments like this by using the equations of statics, and we should transfer the same moments onto the structure. Once we got the final end moments, we can easily sketch the bending moment diagram. So let us sketch the bending moment diagram. So you can sketch the BMD by considering the individual segments. For span AB, so I have moment of 34.28 kilonewton meters to the inward, that is to the right hand side, and 25.72 to the left side. So you can mark the values. Here it is 34.28 28 kilonewton meters, and here I have 25.72 kilonewton meters. And since this column is free from any lateral loadings, you won't get moment because of the applied loading here. That means you won't get span moments here. We have just got the end moments. Now join these points like this. Clear? Now, if you take span BC, again at B, 25.72 is acting in upward direction. Therefore, mark 25.72 in the top. And here, 25.72 is acting in downward direction. So, mark the value here. And join these points. Since there is no loading on span BC, we get the variation like this. And the last segment, that is CD, again at C we have 25.72 to the inward position, it is 25.72, and 34.28 to the outside of the frame, that is to the right side of the frame. And if you join these points, we get the variation of bending moment diagram like this. So this is the BMD for this particular frame, and you can write the notations. You know, for beam, upward moments are positive, downward moments are negative. That means this is a reference line. To the top of the reference line, the moments are positive. To the bottom, the moments are negative. Likewise, for columns, to the left side, the moments are taken as positive, and to the right side, the moments are taken as negative. So this gives me the BMD for the frame given. So now they have asked to sketch the elastic curve also. By looking into the BMD, we can easily sketch the elastic curve. So I have written the dotted diagram of frame. So on this diagram, we can sketch the elastic curve. See, wherever we have got the negative bending moments, at that particular portion, the curve will hog. And at the positive bending moment position, we can get the sagging nature of curve. So here, clear? So in this particular portion, the curve is hogging, and there the bending moment is changing its sign. So you can mark the point of contraflexures at those points. So here also we'll get one point of contraflexion. So this is the elastic curve for the given frame. You just show the sagging and hogging nature of curve at the respective position of positive and negative bending moments. So like this, we can analyze the given portal frames by using flexibility matrix approach. In next session, let us solve one more simple portal frame with different kinds of loading. Thank you.